watching you in the room in the book fever. Love it,
love it.
I'm panting like a Labrador retriever. Love it,
love it.
I swear I never saw a pair of prettier feet. There ought to be a law against you walking down the street. Whoa, love it,
love it.
You're the peak of feminine perfection. Love it,
love it.
There ain't a thing on you that needs correction. To summon up your mind is fine. If I have to trail you like a bloodhound, you know I'm gonna make you mine. I swear I never saw a pair of prettier feet. There ought to be a law against you walking down the street. Perfection. Love it,
love it.
There ain't a thing on you that needs correction. Love it,
love it.
To summon up your mind is fine. If I have to fear you like a bloodhound, you know I'm gonna make you mine. You mine, you mine. You mine, 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 mine.
Our special guest this afternoon on Team Bandstand is a man synonymous with country western music, Mr. Johnny Cash. Welcome to Team Bandstand, Johnny.
Thank you, Morley. Nice to be with you.
Now, maybe we should start. How many million sellers have you actually had?
One.
One?
I walked the line.
That was...
I had about five or six that came close, but never quite made it, you know.
Well, with a little extra push, then they might just go over the mark.
Well, they might someday, I hope.
And you, too, write your own songs, do you not?
Practically all of them. I wrote I Walk the Line, and Don't Take Your Guns to Town, and things like this. I write most of them. Mm-hmm.
Do you have any favorite composer other than, well, the songs you write and sing yourself?
Well, Hank Williams, I think, is a great composer. Marty Robbins is a great composer, I think, in this particular field of music.
Mm-hmm. There's such a thin line between country western music and rockabilly that seems to be going right now. Could you maybe draw the line for us, or do you think there is a distinction?
I don't think there's too much distinction, not much line. You know, we were sitting around the other night talking about songs and singing in the room after the show, and we were taking the country songs and jazzing them up and taking the rock and roll songs and singing them like ballads, and it comes out pretty funny. You know, but sometimes it sounds all right. Mm-hmm. I don't think there's much of a line.
Very good. And have you got any words of, kind of success, you might say, for anybody attempting to get into the singing field now?
Well, I'd say try to develop your own style. Know what you want to do, and then work your fingers off for it.
It's just like...
It's like anything else, really. Yeah.
Be sure you're right, and then go ahead.
Yeah, okay.
Thanks very much, our... guest this afternoon on Team Bandstand, Johnny Cash.
And of course, you know, Johnny Cash appeared with the Grand Old Opry Show Wednesday night here at the Gardens. And also this afternoon, a little later on in Team Bandstand, we're going to be having an interview with Laurie and Larry, the Collins kids.
Thank you.
Aaron King and the Barry Boyd Quintet, and of course, maybe. Many of you folks at home are wondering how you can drop down here and join us. Well, it's very simple. All you have to do is drop down to the CPR building and pick up tickets. That's at CFRN Radio. Now, the time is limited, from 12 noon until 2 o'clock Sunday afternoon. Usually they're gone before 2 o'clock, so if you're planning on getting some, try to be there at 12 noon. Also, the only and the few stipulations we have is we don't have any dress rule exactly as yet, although jeans and things like that, you know, we just like you to dress accordingly, up to your own judgment actually, and over 15 years of age. There is a few under, because the tickets were printed wrong a little earlier. We were giving tickets to people out of town a month in advance, so some were sneaking through, but it's 15 and over now. Sunday afternoons from 12 noon until 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so if you want to get tickets for next week's show, you drop down to the CFRN Radio tomorrow at 12 o'clock noon. Our next disc is by D. Clark, his brand new one that I think is going to go places. It's called Knockin' at My Front Door.
All Irishmen. Hannigan's opposite the Avenue Theater and in the West End are celebrating St. Patrick's starting today. Irish treats, Irish snacks, Irish meals, and an Irish welcome to all. Once a year, low prices on Hannigan's famous menu. So if you'd like some wonderful eating and some wonderful savings, meet your friends at Hannigan's in Inglewood and on 118th Avenue.
Right, that's good news too, Hannigan's. You drop down there and taste some of their delicious goods, because they are terrific. Barry Boyd Quintet back again. We're going to dance all afternoon. A lot of dancing, a lot of music. This one's called Rockin' Crickets. Thank you. Rocky gets crickets with the Barry Boyd Quintet. Morley's all set up to talk to some of the gang, but just before he does, I'd like to remind you that 3TV goes VTR.
Thank you very much, George, for the very kind words. And I just stepped down here and everybody crowded away. I think we're going to have to go after him. Can you come, Des? And before you sneak away, hi.
Hi.
Maybe you could come over here where my mic cord can reach. And give the folks at home a gander. Can we have your name, first ladies?
Vicky Mills.
Where are you from, Vicky?
Beverly.
From Beverly.
Yes.
Welcome into Edmonton. And?
Robin Pinfold.
And?
Beverly, too.
From Beverly, too. Both in high school?
Yes,
yeah,
sir.
Oh, now, I've got a good question for you this afternoon. As you know, the Cameron Commission on Education has recommended longer school hours. What do you think of it?
Longer?
I don't think they should.
And, Rob?
They're crazy.
Well, they're, yeah. They've also recommended something about compulsory homework. Now, do you agree with this, or do you think that the teenager of today does enough homework to get by on?
Well, I think that most of them could use a little bit more, but others, they don't need it. Just depends.
Yeah, do you think it should be compulsory, or do you think it should be left up to the individual?
Left up to the individual.
Robin?
I don't know.
Well, okay, we'll take yourself for instance. Now, do you do homework that you absolutely don't have to do?
No.
Welcome to the club. But do you feel it would be of any assistance to you if you were forced to?
Might be.
Well, thanks very much for being so very frank this afternoon. For you, Ernie Fields, Chattanooga Choo Choo.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And it's back to dancing now with the Barry Boyd Quintet featuring their vocalist, Nat.
Uh-oh, forgot. Nat, help me out.
I woke up this morning, my baby was gone. Woke up this morning, my baby was gone. I feel so bad, I'm all alone. I ain't got nobody to stay home with me. Don't have nobody to stay home with me. My baby, she's gone, I'm in misery.
This morning, and I woke up right now and found out that I had to learn to dance. So, Ronnie, why don't you come in here and see if we can accomplish something today. I know a little bit about this. This hasn't got a name, this dance. It's the type of dance, I believe, that you do to jazzy-type music, right?
That's
in
relation,
in comparison to rock and roll. Also, we're going to do it to Little Susie Part 4. That's all I know, so take it from there.
Well, this dance is done usually by kids that are 19, 18. It's not done by kids 15 or 16 years.
Well, okay, just for this time, we're not going to be... Well, everybody can learn this.
Well, everybody
today,
can learn
today, everybody does this dance. I mean, if I can do it, I can't dance any better than a 15. I can't dance any better than a 10-year-old. Come on, let's fake it.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, if I can have some music, I'll have to have music.
All right,
to show
fine. A little music weigh in, please.
Okay. This foot goes out.
What are you doing here now?
Now. This
kick.
Is forward.
Kick.
Forward. One, two, three. And you bring this one, slide it back,
yeah.
And you just drag this across this way.
Okay, now let's see.
One.
One, two, three. Count this out. Can you count this out? Is
I
that
think
how
so.
You, you count it out? I imagine
no.
It is.
Okay. It's one,
two,
one, two, three.
Round. Side. One, two, three.
Front.
One, left.
Two,
one, two, three. Back. Slide.
One, two, three.
Right? Front?
If you get, you have to get him this way. You know,
well, slow, when you're doing it slow, actually, it's your right foot out and your left foot out.
That's right.
And your left foot back, your right foot across, just sideways, and one, two, three, right?
That's right.
And then left foot out, right foot out, one, two, three, left foot back, right foot across, one, two, three. Is this right?
That's right.
All right. Did you get that?
Does anybody get anything out of that?
You think you got that a little bit? All right, try it once more time.
It's real simple. All right, the block is this way. All right, now you've got that motion, right? All right, now you put this foot out, this foot, one, two, three, round, and slide.
Right foot forward, left foot forward, one, two, three.
That's
left
right.
Foot back.
It's very right. Easy. You just have to remember this foot goes forward.
Of course, it doesn't look as easy as it is. I mean, this way it looks a little bit tough, so I can understand your problem. But I think I know what you mean. So if we can get that one started right over from the top, Ray Bryant Trio and Little Susie Part 4, and we'll give it a try, all right? I'll change sides with you. And a little later on, you can join in, all right? Music. Try it. Come on, gang. Everybody dance.
Little Susie Part 3 this time around. Well, on Wednesday night too, we had a wee talk, and a very pleasant talk it was too. I think you'll see what I mean in just a few moments. We have a short chat now with Laurie and Larry Collins, the Collins Kids.
And again, special guest on Team Bandstand this afternoon, the Collins Kids, Laurie and Larry. Welcome to Team Bandstand.
Oh, thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
And, Larry, the people that saw the show will undoubtedly ask, what makes you jump around?
Oh, I don't know. I was born that way. I guess I'll be that way all my life. I just jump around like that all the time. When I hear music, I start jumping, you know, like an idiot.
And maybe you could tell the folks at home how long you have been playing guitar.
I've been playing for about 7 years, guitar.
How do you find education on the road?
Well, I go to a school called Hollywood Professional in Hollywood, and when I go on the road, it's like a correspondence course. I do my work and then I send it in, and then sometimes I have a tutor.
And not neglecting the fairer half of this common kid. How long have you been singing?
Since I was 10, 7 years.
7 years?
Uh-huh.
Boy. And how long have you been singing professionally?
6 years.
6 years?
Yes.
Took you a year to break.
Well, I guess you could say that. It took longer than that, but it took a year to get on a TV show.
I see. And do you plan on carrying this as long as you can, like traveling and show business?
Well, we love it. We want to. That's what we want to do.
Mm-hmm. And have you any plans for marriage?
Well, I am married.
You are married?
Yes,
sorry,
I am.
Sorry, Bachelor. How long have you been married?
A year now.
A year?
Yes, uh-huh.
Does this traveling infringe at all upon marital relations?
Well, no, because my husband travels too. He's Johnny Cash's manager.
Very nice.
So it works out pretty good.
I see. And, well, you being teenagers yourself, more or less, could you kind of give our teenagers a hint as to how to break it if they can?
Well, gee, there's really not a way. If they want to sing and they want to play, I think the best way that they can do it is just to stay with it and practice and get better all the time.
Uh-huh. And Larry?
I agree with Lori get your own style, you know?
Get your own style. Same advice as Johnny.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And very good advice, too. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you very much, Colin twins or kids or whatever you are. Wonderful pair they are, too. Oh, Morley, asking them if they're married already. Where are you, Morley? Hustling, you know. Oh, well, we're going to have a little contest now. We've got five chairs up here. We picked five people to be judges a little earlier on, just before the show, to be exact. Where are they? How'd you like to come on right up here and have a chair? Now, the gals can sit. Yeah, that's right. One of you fellas, come over here. Come on, now, don't be bashful. All right, there you are. Now, you know how this works? Have you seen it before? You've all seen it before. Now, what I want you to do is pick five. Each pick a different couple out that you think is your favorite, dancing the best, all right? And I want to explain to you kids dancing that this is it's not anything personal if you aren't picked. It's just, we've got five kids and myself, just personal opinions, and no feeling should be hurt. All right, now we're going to pick five, and then we'll play another song, and those five will whittle it down to one. And we'll see if we can come up with a winner to come back in 2 or 3 weeks' time to compete in the finals, we'll call them. So for our first number for you to dance to, we're going to call them the Barry Boyd Quintet and Cottonwood. Thank you. Barry Boyd Quintet and a hand to all the dancers and a hand to the judges. And have you come up with any kind of a decision? You think you got five? All right, let's try it from this end. And before you give your decision, what's your name? Give your name and who you pick.
Betty Peterson.
And Betty, who do you choose?
That girl over there in the red skirt and top with the green sweater.
Right here. And the boy, of course, you know. He was doing his share. Come on right up here, will you please? Name and
judge. Norman Champagne.
Norman?
Yes.
Okay, Norman, who did you pick?
Bernard, the one with the yellow neckerchief.
Yellow neckerchief, and come on right up here. Bring your girlfriend with you, all right?
Right there.
Which one is that?
The girl in the blue dress with the gray.
The girl right here in front of us, all right. Uh-huh. And your name, please.
Sandy Simden.
Sandy.
Peter Horn, and that girl in the black sweater and the black skirt.
Black sweater and black skirt. Where's the gal with the black skirt? Right back there? Yeah, you. All right, come on up here. One more.
Linda Marquardt, the boy in the shag sweater and the glasses.
All right. And his girlfriend.
Yes.
Some of you pick girls, others say the boys, eh? Maybe that's a trait of personality. Okay, now just for a few moments, if I could ask the rest of you to just move back a little bit and come back. Don't go away. I want you five to dance, and we're going to come up with one selection. All right? You all set to go? A few minutes ago, we heard this, pardon me, Ray Bryant Trio and Little Susie Part 4. Now we're going to hear his Part 3. Okay, there we had it, the Ray Brown Trio and Little Susie Part 3. It sounds just like 4 to me. I think we've come up with one couple. Your spokesman's down this end, I understand, eh? All right. What's the verdict?
The girl with the black sweater and the black skirt and her partner.
Right here in front of us? Mm-hmm. All right, come on up here and talk to me. Your names, please.
Vicky Mills.
Vicky?
Ron Pinfold.
And Ron, where are you from, Ron?
Beverly.
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 Come in for the show, of course. That's not very far away, Beverly. I was thinking it was out of town. Tell you what we got here. Can we get a shot of this album? We had one of the cameras on here. A tremendous album that I'd like you to bring home or take home, each one of you. Featuring Dinah Washington, the Platters, Brooke Benton, oh, Phil Phillips, Sarah Vaughan, Ralph Martiri, the Diamonds, David Carroll, oh, Bobby Bennett, Boyd Bennett, pardon me, a whole slew of tremendous artists, 14 of the biggest hits. And I'm sure you'll enjoy it. You've got a record player?
Yeah.
Have you? You've got one? Good. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. There's one for you and one for you. And before you go after the show, will you give me your names and addresses? You see me after the show, all right? Thanks very much. And we'll fix you up and you up in just a few minutes. Right now, Morley's got some good news for us. Morley?
Well, thank you very much, George, and for all the teens that are looking for something to do tonight and throughout the coming week. Here are the dance dates. There's a dance at Bentley Saturday, March 12th from 9 to 12. That's tonight with Dick Dameron and his band. The Rocket Tunes are playing tonight at Panoka Community Hall, dancing from 9 to 12. The Lords will be playing in the Bonnie Doon Community Hall at 92nd Avenue and 93rd Street tonight, starting at 8 o'clock. The Traditional Jazz Society presents the Tailgate Jazz Band every Wednesday night from 9:30 through until 11:30 at Baroni's on the south side. And might just say that we were over at Baroni's the other night, and for all of you old-timers that do like to jive, you know, not to bop, jiving is definitely the thing over there at Baroni's on the south side. The Counts are having a spring splash in the East Edmonton Community Hall, March 18th. That's on next Saturday, 2 miles east on Highway 14 at 8:30. And of course, the Ravens are playing tonight at the East Edmonton Hall from 8:30 through until 12. And don't forget the Barry Boyd Quintet that's featured this afternoon on Team Bandstand will be seen in Ross Shepherd High School next Friday, March 18th. And that's all we have for right now. George?
I'm here. Having just a little bit of trouble. If you noticed a little while ago, you saw a good shot of my back. Well, that broke the camera. One of our cameras went on the blink after that, so we'll have to, you'll have to excuse us. It's the Barry Boyd Quintet again with Nat and Karen both singing Lee Goof.
Standing now beside our 1960 stereophonic Seaberg hi-fi combination record player from Crown Music. And here's a number we found on the Crown Music menu. It's a tune called Tough Stuff, Mr. Johnny Silver.
Woke up this morning feeling mighty low. Spent all my money and no place to go. Just lying here, flat on my back. Half past two and I'm still in that sack. Feeling rough, yeah, tough stuff. Went into town late last night. Spent all my money and I got in a fight. My gal ran off with another man. She said I was a fool and a fool what I am. Feeling rough, yeah, that's what I said, tough stuff. Borrowed me a dollar and I bought a pint of wine. Drank all of that and I sure felt fine. Felt so good that I bought me another. I made it through the night, but this morning, old brother, feeling rough. Woo! Tough stuff. Now for all you smart guys that need a good tip, you ought to stay at home and button your lip. Don't fight and drink until your mind's out of sight. Find you a gal and love her every night. I tell you it's rough, yeah, tough stuff. Ooh, this show is a drag. I feel so bad, think I'm gonna sleep some more. Keep it in mind, boys, this show is tough, tough.
Tough stuff.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
This isn't tough stuff. Oh, you want to know what's delicious in here? Come on over here and take a look at this, Kurt. Can you come on? Can you get in here and get a shot of this? And I'll unveil this prize. How about that, eh? Delicious hamburger. And look at...
You know what's George?
Oh, look. Look what we got.
I'm just wishing this was Smell-O-Vision.
I will wrap it up again. Smell-O-Vision. Oh. Well, that is it, don't they? Okay. We talked about Hannigan's just a little earlier. Well, here we have a whole slew of hamburgers from Hannigan's. Delicious they are, too. And right now, I'd like the kids to come filing up here and filing up here, and we'll give them away. In the meantime, we're going to listen to the Barry Boyd Quintet one, Be My Guest.
Baby, and be my guest. Come meet the body, see the rest. Everything's gonna be all right. So be my guest tonight.
Be my guest, and you can be the Barry Boyd Quintet's guest. That's next Friday evening at Ross Shepherd High School, I believe, right? We've got a little time on our hands. What can you dig out of the hat?
Torque.
Torque? All right, here we go. Torque. Thank you.
that? Torquay, while we've got time for another disc and our guest, not quite in the show, but practically, is Marv Johnson. And when the kids dance, there might not be too many dancing because they're all over there enjoying the delicious Hannigan hamburger. So we'll go solo with a few couples that are sticking her out. Marv Johnson, and You've Got What It Takes.
But baby, you got what it takes to satisfy. You got what it takes to set my soul on fire. Whoa, oh yeah, you got what it takes for me. Now you don't live in a beautiful place. You don't dress with the best of taste. And nature didn't give you such a beautiful face. But baby, you got what it takes to satisfy. You got what it takes to set my soul on fire. Whoa, 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 oh yeah. You got what it takes for me. Now when you're near me, ooh-wee, my head goes around and around. And when you kiss me, oh yeah, my love comes tumbling down. You send me, you don't live in a beautiful place. You don't dress with the best of taste. And nature didn't give you such a beautiful face. But baby, you got what it takes to satisfy. You got what it takes to set my soul on fire. You got what it takes for me. Now when you're near me, little girl, my head goes round and round. And when you kiss me, oh yeah, my love comes tumbling down. You send me, you don't live in a beautiful place. You don't dress with the best of taste. And nature didn't give you such a beautiful face. But baby, you got what it takes, hey, hey, to satisfy. Hey, hey. You got what it takes to set my soul on fire. Whoa, oh yeah. You got what it takes for me. Oh yeah. You got what it takes. Don't need no money. Baby, you don't need no car.
Well, you don't need much money to get one of these hamburgers, believe me. I can't eat it right now. I'd love to. I can't talk too good when my mouth is full. It's not very polite. Barry, how would you like to come down here and talk to me for just a second here? We've met Nat and Karen and yourself. How would you like to introduce very briefly the rest of the boys of the band?
Okay, on the piano we have Ron Johnson.
Ron Johnson.
Guitar we have Bob Karen.
And up there in the drums?
Joe Wade. And on sax, Dave Nash.
There they are, the Barry Boyd Quintet. Of course, Ron here played with the Playboys before, didn't he? I thought I saw him somewhere. Okay, we've got time for one more song. Not a song, actually. It's a tune. It's called the Guitar Boogie Shuffle. If your fingers last up. Thank you.
There they go, the Barry Boyd Quintet. And that was, of course, Guitar Boogie Shuffle. And I was going to light into this hamburger, this Hannigan burger, and then I saw that George was, so it looks like George can't talk with his mouth full, so I'll keep talking until George... Bad boy.
I'm swallowed. You have a dance to remind the gang of, haven't you?
Well, yes. First of all, I'd like to thank the Beverly Teen Group for coming out this afternoon. We forgot to acknowledge them a little earlier on in the show. And also the dance tonight at Sherwood Hall.
Wonderful.
No, pardon me, Bonnie Doon Hall. Bonnie Doon Hall. Don't forget it.
Wonderful
and,
hamburgers.
I'd like to thank, too, the Barry Boyd Quintet for appearing this afternoon, George.
Wonderful hamburgers.
He's got a one-track mind.
What have we got next week, Morley?
Well, next week, well, what we have every week. The biggest and best show in Northern Alberta.
Lined up next week.
That's for sure.
We'll make sure you're there. How about a little theme with Santo and Johnny behind us? I like that music, you know.
Oh, that's crazy swinging stuff.
This is the all-night diner. Flip side is sleep.
The all-night diner, and we're going to stand here and eat. How's that sound?
Yeah, we're going to dine while watch the kids dance and sign off the show. We'll see you next week.
Bye for now.
It's not bad stuff.
It's real good stuff.
This has been Teen Bandstand setting the pace for Northern and Central Alberta teenagers. Join us again next Saturday at 4 for more fun and prizes. Teen Bandstand is produced and directed by Herbert Arthur Ashley and originated live from Channel 3's Studio A.